Lieutenant Colonel and the command staff, welcome. Thank you for being here today. Wanted to circle back for a moment to discuss the PICS, or the Pennsylvania Instant Check System, a little bit further. Wanted to applaud and also give you the opportunity to expand on it a little bit, but in your statement, I noticed that you comment the system in 2018, the PICS system handled over 1 million interactive voice response system, IVR, and web background checks. The system downtime was, again, limited to less than 1%. There were 11,127 PICS background denials reported. In addition, 162 fugitives were identified and apprehended through the background check process because of the discovery of outstanding warrants for the individual attempting to obtain a firearm or license to carry. To me, again, I applaud the robust program. Sounds like something that I wish, and one could only hope, you were empowered to expand that and take it further to all firearm sales. Perhaps that will happen someday. But traditionally, the system's been funded from a mix of fee revenue. I know Representative Schweier touched on it earlier with the $5 fee not entirely covering the cost of the background check. But wanted to hear from you gentlemen, what would be the best way to fund that system?
Well, sir, in some of these funding decisions, we always defer to the good judgment of the legislature. Having said that, PICS is currently funded from three sources. It's general governmental operations, the actual PICS check fees, and then a gun check appropriation, which this year I believe the gun check appropriation requested was $4.4 million. PICS costs a total of between $6 and $8 million per year to operate. Now, it's hard to estimate because the 1 million transactions that you mentioned, about 300,000 to 350,000 of those are actually performed for the sheriff's offices to do license to carry checks. So there is some legislatively mandated fee we get back from those, but of those, about 700,000 are actually performed for firearms purchase decisions. So those are the ones that are really their end user fees, those 700,000. And we can't estimate the volume of firearms transactions. Now, we've generally seen a lineal increase year to year. After Sandy Hook, there was a significant spike. The presumption was that would potentially fall down to a lineal increase, but in fact, it plateaued. So we've been relatively consistent in the sense that there have been about 700 to 750,000 gun transfers per year, onto which those fees, that $2 or $5 fee would be assessed. But we don't know. If gun sales go up, we generate more in the actual gun checks. If gun sales go down, we generate less. But it would be our position that the viability and the valuableness of PICS is such that potentially increasing the cost of the PICS check to that recommended by the Legislative and Budget Finance Committee, which does an evaluation every 5 years because the legislature was prescient in including that to say that LBFC has to do an evaluation every 5 years. And the actual title of the evaluation is Determine the Adequacy of PICS Fees. That suggests that there was legislative intent at that time to ensure that the PICS fees were adequate to support the operation. So we would suggest that is a viable consideration and something that we would leave to the good judgment of the legislature to consider.
Thank you, sir. And just to follow up on that, given the ebb and flow of gun sales, if background checks were expanded further, is there still capacity in the system to handle that, or would that be the actual technical system, not the financing? Would that be viable, or would that require further expansion?
It's an interesting question because we don't know what we don't know. It's very difficult to estimate the number of person-to-person private transactions not subject to a PICS check at this moment in time. We've done a lot of extrapolations and looked at permutations and combinations, and ultimately where we come out is we could see 40,000 more PICS checks per year, or we could see 100,000. But if you look at the number of PICS checks, PICS really hasn't expanded in terms of our staffing since 1998. when we did 200,000 checks per year, and now we're doing 1 million checks per year. The systems, the technology systems, they can support it. But we would like to maintain our current level of customer service, so it remains to be seen whether we would be able to adequately staff or whether we would have to look at potentially moving staff to bolster our numbers.
Thank you again, sir. I see my time's expired. Thank you, Mr. Chairman.